Hi everyone. Today I will make a tutorial about a cute effect that we can do easily in Figma, which is kind of the before and after. Let's say if you take an image and you, I don't know, adjust the colors or anything you want to show like before and after. So that's definitely a cute way of doing it. And it's actually very easy. I am going to work with the clip content ability on a frame in Figma. You can do the same with a mask, okay? The result will be identical, but I will do it today with the clip content, and let's see how we do that, and it's going to be actually really easy, okay? So let's jump in and see exactly how we do it. I'm gonna take a shape, just a square shape, rectangle, something like that, which is good. I'm gonna copy properties and paste them into here. So now we have the image inside that rectangle. So far, so good. And I'm gonna duplicate this, Control D or Command D on Mac. And what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna edit the colors of this image. I'll make it like more saturated, like more colors, and I will change the way that it looks. And that is okay. I'm exaggerating on purpose just for the sake of this tutorial, even though the colors look nice anyway. So we have these two images right now, one on top of the other, okay? So I'm gonna have to decide, or you know, you guys can decide, of course, which any with the let's say with the two images that you do, whatever you do in your designs, which one is on top and which one is underneath it. So just, you know, of course you are free to choose anyway. So let's do it like that. I'm gonna do the after, okay? The after image is gonna be below it. And yeah, so I will just choose or select the second image, and I will frame it so I can either do it easily from here or just, you know, draw a frame on it. But I will just frame selection, and that's it. So we have the second one in a frame, and that's enough. I mean, we need only the second one because the one below it is just gonna stay there, okay? And we're gonna show and hide it as we animate, actually, with the drag interaction. I will do it in an interactive component, and you can do it also by animating or interacting with two screens. The logic, by the way, is exactly the same, okay? So anyway, it doesn't really matter how you do it. Interactive component, if you don't have it, you can do exactly, I mean, if you didn't registered in Figma, you know, that form that you have to fill and have it open on your Figma, so you can do exactly what I'm doing here, interacting between two frames, I mean between two screens. It doesn't matter, it's the same thing. I mean, the logic is actually the same, okay? What I'm gonna do here more to add to our to the items that we will work with, I'm just gonna do something very simple like that. I'm gonna give it a white color, and I'm gonna take it outside the frame. By the way, I don't want it inside the frame. And I'm gonna take also a circle, just to do an ellipse, something like that. Of course, you are totally free to do in your designs whatever suits you right, whatever sits good with your designs. Here I'm just doing it in a very simple way, so just ignore let's say the elements that I'm working here with. You can do it either like a square, or just I don't know, some kind of, like, you know, a circle with an icon, anything that you feel right. Okay, so I'm just going to give it a white color. I'm going to give it a shadow, take it a bit, like, I'll just do that. That's okay. I can give it an icon, yes, no, it doesn't really matter. Okay, really, it just to understand technically how to do it. So this is what I'm working with. The other thing that I want to do, let's see, that we are sitting here in the center of the screen. It's okay, we're gonna take it outside the frame anyway. The other thing that I'm gonna do here is maybe I'll just do kind of like a before, do like that, give it a, I don't know, 30 sounds looks okay, doesn't sound, it looks, yeah, it looks okay. Before, and I'm gonna do here the after. We can do it actually, yeah, it doesn't matter anyway, you can just play with it after in any side you want or any way you want, that's okay. And here I'm just gonna write after. Okay, now this one, for now I'm gonna take all this construction that I did here and I'm just gonna drag it outside here. And let me see, yeah, okay, so this one, okay, let me just duplicate them. I'm gonna group it, no, I'm gonna frame it. Okay, I'm gonna frame it. Okay, I'm gonna frame it and call it before. Okay, and now I'm just gonna duplicate this frame and I'm gonna call it after. Okay, now what I do want to do is to check, just to see that we have the same elements when we are animating. If it's by drag or tap, we need to make sure, of course, that we have the same names of the elements that we are working with when we are doing it with Smart Animate, because otherwise it's not going to work. Okay, if I have, let's say, an image which is in frame one, and that image is rectangle one, here it needs to be the same, frame one, and inside there is an image in rectangle one. Okay, it needs to be the same, otherwise it just wouldn't be able to, we wouldn't be able to animate it properly. Okay, what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna take this circle and this white line that we made here, and I'm just gonna put it here, and I'm gonna make sure it's not inside the frame because I don't want it there, so I just drag it. Sometimes by dragging elements above a frame, it's just naturally gonna enter inside the frame, and this is not what I want here. Other cases could work. Excellent. Okay, so that's not what I want right now. And another thing is that I want to the after here, I'm gonna give it a 0% opacity, and here I'm gonna do exactly the opposite, 0 opacity. And here I'm gonna take this frame. Now listen, when I'm resizing a frame, the frame in general can be resized regardless the content that is inside of it. Right now, this rectangle, which its fill is the image that we placed inside, this is the content of this frame. Now, if I will make it smaller, okay, look what happens. It goes with the frame itself. Why? Because it's sticking to the top left always. So what I'm gonna do is I'll do Control Z or Command Z in Mac. I can hit the control key on my keyboard, and when I do it, I can just resize the frame. Sorry, oh yeah, it's okay. I mean, The only thing that I didn't do yet, okay, is I need to do the clip content. That's why, by the way, because the clip content is not on, and the clip content says actually or means that the content that is outside the frame, it's not visible. Okay, so look, when I hit the clip content, you're not going to see the content which is outside the frame, and this is how we are getting the image below it. Okay, so that's how the magic actually happens, and I'm going to keep on pressing my control, and there we go. Okay, so we have the before and the after. The only thing that we have to do now is actually turn each one of them into a component. Okay, we're going to combine them as variants and interact between them. And we're going to do this interaction with these circles, with the circle actually. Okay, that in the first one it's here, and on the other one it's here. So that's the animation, and it's gonna drag with it the frame itself, the frame size actually, that what we did here. So let's go for it. So I'm having these two frames selected, and here I can hit the create multiple components. Okay, if I'm gonna create a component, it's gonna take these two frames and just put them as one component. This is not what we want. Okay, here, by the way, and one thing, I don't see that circle. Why is that ellipse? Yeah, okay, I just wanted to make sure it's inside what we need. Okay, so here actually what I'm gonna do is create multiple components, and that means that it will take each frame, and one second, something is wrong here. What is that image? Oh, it's this one. Sorry, I got confused. I thought that one of my images just stayed out. Okay, sorry about that. Yeah, so that's not we don't need it anymore. Anyway, so what I'm doing here now is I'm creating multiple components, and that means that it takes the before and makes it a one component, and the after and makes it one component. Okay, so we have here two components. This is one, and this is the second. Now we can just close it here. Okay, and now I am selecting both of them, and I combine them as variants. Here they are combined now as two variants of the same component. Okay. Now, the only thing that is left to do is actually to interact, to create the interaction between these two variants. I'm gonna double click on that circle, and I'm gonna go to the prototype. By the way, the logic of animating, interacting between two variants is the same logic, exactly identical, of doing it between two frames, I mean two screens. It's the same exact thing. The logic is practically the same. Okay, so I'm gonna drag this one to here. On tap, no, I want it on drag, change to, and I'm gonna use the smart animate. Okay, I'm gonna do it 500 milliseconds, and I am explaining the speed of the interaction is actually happening. It's the speed of, I mean, how fast do we drag our mouse? Okay, or if we check it on mobile, for example, is how fast are we dragging it, doing this interaction, the swiping, kind of swiping interaction or dragging interaction more in this case, with our finger. But the nature of this interaction, of the dragging interaction, is if we do let's say up to 50% or less than 50% of the movement and leave it, it's going to go back to the start. And if we pass 50% of this interaction, it's gonna, and we leave it actually, and I'm gonna, let's say, move my mouse or my finger, so it's gonna finish it until the end of it. And that is where the 500 milliseconds actually takes place. Okay, so that's why I'm also doing this duration, and I'm gonna take this one to here. The same thing, it's not on tap, it's on drag. Change to smart animate is out, is fine for me. For this case, it's totally okay. And 500 milliseconds. So I think it looks like we are actually done. We can call this component before and after. And then we have the after and the before inside of it. Okay, this how, because there are two variants of the same component. And what we will do now is we will take this child component actually and put it here, and let's check our animation. Let's see how it looks. I'm gonna place it a bit like that, and let's hit the play and see what we got. Hopefully it works. Let's see. Okay, you see, but I see here something, let me see, a bit weird. I mean, it is working, okay, but here there's some kind of, it shouldn't be like that. Let me see what it happens. Let me see, let me check what's going on there. Okay, so we have the before, we have after, ellipse 3, frame 1, rectangle. Okay, and let's see that here we are working with identical things. Let me see. Oh, I know why. Okay, I understand now. Because here, if you remember, this frame, actually, I mean, the frame that holds the image, you see, I have it here on clip content. On the first one, actually, I didn't define it. So if you see that kind of, I mean, it is working, but there is some kind of, like, you see, it's not starting exactly from the beginning of the dragging. It's kind of like, I mean, the after is kind of fading in, and this is not what I wanted to achieve here. So I'm gonna hit this frame. I think that this is the problem. I'm gonna give it a clip content as well on the first one. Okay, and now, okay, now we are doing perfect. Okay, so this is how it goes, and it works perfect. And if you do want to start it, let's say from the middle, all you have to do actually is add another variant, okay, which will start from the middle, and then you can drag it either to the left side or the right side. But again, the logic is actually the same. You just hit another variant, just duplicate it, and you can take it, this line and circle or whatever you're gonna do in your design, to the middle. You can resize the frame, you know, the frame that this one is now revealed totally. So you can take this frame, do it up to the middle, and do the same. Okay, so the logic is pretty much the same again. So we have the before and after, you see, working beautifully. And I hope you found this tutorial practical and that it fits your needs. And of course, you can also hit the subscribe button. I will be happy. And more very cool tutorials are definitely on the way. So thank you guys for watching, and see you on the next tutorial.